Hi there, welcome to Mini Math Lessons with Karen. Today I'm working with the fx9750GII Casio graphing calculator. It's whatever I'm doing today, just so you know, because Casio is so consistent with its buttons and its functionality that if you have the 9860 or the CG10 or the CG50, all these steps would be the same. The difference being maybe the menu has some slightly different more objects on it, or it might be in a different order, but the steps are basically the same. So that's a nice thing about it. So what I wanted to do today was share two activities, both on solving systems of equations. If you used both of these by the end, students would have worked with solving by elimination, solving by substitution, solving or verifying answers by using the calculator and its simultaneous equation solver, and also solving by graphing. So lots of different ways. The whole idea is here to show you multiple ways to solve and multiple representations of that. So the first activity is called solving systems of equations, and you'll notice it's a complete lesson. It has standards and objectives and getting started. There's some how-tos on the calculator, which I'm going to be showing, so I'm going to kind of skip right over that. The activity itself, you'll notice, actually kind of goes through first, what is substitution? How do you solve equations? What does that mean? And then they practice it a little bit. And then it gives them another strategy, which is elimination. And again, we show examples and we practice a little bit. And then there's some application of that, different ways to solve, kind of combining elimination, substitution, that type of thing. The calculator in this case is actually used, they are doing all the work by doing these steps, you know, the substitution, the elimination. But the calculator then is used to verify their solutions, how they do. So in this particular case, we're going to be using the equation menu here. So I'm going to arrow down. Once I have it selected, I'm going to hit execute, and it brings me into the options here. And I want to do simultaneous because I have two or more equations that I'm trying to solve at the same time, find their intersection point or points. So I'm going to choose F1. And then the first thing it asks me is how many unknowns. So notice I have an X and a Y, two unknowns. I could have 3, 4, 5, but in this case I have 2. So I'm going to choose F1 again because it's under the 2. Whoops, and let's clear that out. And so all you're going to do is, let's go back up, is enter your unknowns into these positions. So notice that the equation, it has it where the constant is on the other side of the equal sign. So we could have students move that manually to check it. So we're gonna just use this equation right here to help us. Let's use this one because it's in the right order. So all you're gonna do is, it's basically like matrices. You're gonna enter in each position, row, column. So the first row is our first equation. Each column represents my coefficient or constants. So in this first one, and I'm using this equation here, I'm gonna enter a 3. And negative 2, and then an 8. So every time I enter a number, hit execute to set it. So now we go down to the second equation, and the value there is 1, and then the 5 for the y. Whoops, what did I do here? I must have hit the wrong thing. 1, execute, there we go. 5, execute, and then negative 3. Once I have it set, then I solve it. So I'm verifying my solution, right? So I hit solve, and there is my solution, the point 2, negative 1. So hopefully students who have done their work now can say, oh, okay, I did it right, I got it right. If not, where did I make a arithmetic mistake or something along those lines? So that is using simultaneous equation solver. Pretty easy. And again, the steps are in the activity if you forget. Let's go to the second activity, and I'm going to exit out and get back to my menu here. This time, another way to solve systems, as we know, is that you can graph the equations that you have and look for those points of intersection, the point where they have in common. So again, this is a complete lesson, has standards, what you're supposed to do, what's your objective, and there is a how-to, so I'm going to skip over that because that's what I'm showing you, but I just wanted to show you the activity. So notice the activity actually starts with some graphs. How can you determine if there's no solution, one solution, those types of things. And we talk about parallel and stuff. And then they practice identifying points of solutions. And then we're going to graph. And then notice that now we have some application problems. So they're going to have some real world where they have to not only create the equation, then graph the equation, and then find the solution, but most importantly, what does that solution mean in the context of the problem? So what I want to show you is how you can graph and find solutions. So first thing you want to do is go up to the graph menu, wherever that is, on whichever calculator you're using, and hit execute. And that brings us to where you enter your equations. So let's actually scroll up here to one of these equations. So let's enter the first one. So y equals 2, and here's my x right here is where I put my variable in, plus 1. I've set my equation, so I hit execute. Now let's enter the second equation. I'm doing this number 4 here. So negative x minus 2, and execute to set. So now that I have both equations, I'm going to hit draw. And that's under F6, so I hit F6. And I can't see it, so this means I must need to see, I must change my window, right? So maybe we want to try initial and see what that does, that brings us. And so then let's hit draw again. And so there I now can see my intersection. So if you can't see the intersection or both lines or equations, basically, make sure you change your window. Good practice for the students. So now I have this... I see where the point is, but it's really kind of hard to see on this the menu, but we can go to this G solve right here. So shift G solve, and I have lots of things I could find. I could find roots, the max, the min. It does make sense in a linear, but I could find y intercept, but I want the intersection. I want the intersection of these two different equations. So I'm going to choose F5 because that is under intersect. And it will give me that intersection right away. And then the important thing, if I were using this as, say, a problem, the solution to this problem here, I would want to explain what does that point mean in the context of that solution. So that's what we really want students getting to. And if you had, you know, more than one intersection, you could toggle between the two of them. But in this case, we just have two lines. They're going to intersect at one point. So good activities, lots of different ways to try and solve systems of equations. So a good way to show some multiple solution pathways for students.